In a previous episode whose title is Bohr Model of the Hydrogen Atom, we have identified the energy levels of the hydrogen atom, but from where we got these values? In this episode, we are going to determine the expression which gives the values of the energy levels using Bohr model and Rydberg formula. Let's start. According to Bohr model, when an atom undergoes a downward transition from an energy level of quantum number n to an energy level of quantum number m, the atom emits a photon. The energy of this photon equals the energy difference between these two levels. En is the higher energy level and Em is the lower energy level. Let me remind you with Rydberg formula. Now, let's use this equation and this equation in order to determine the energy of these levels. First, the energy of the photon can be written as hc times 1 over lambda. Let me replace 1 over lambda by its expression from Rydberg formula. You will get this expression. This is going to be hcr over m squared minus hcr over n squared, which is equal to minus hcr over n squared plus hcr over m squared. This is going to be minus hcr over n squared minus into minus hcr over m squared. Now, let's compare this equation with this equation. Therefore, En equals minus hcr over n squared and Em equals minus hcr over m squared.
Now, let's determine the expression of the energy levels of the hydrogen atom. The energy level of a quantum number n is given by this relation. Since h, c, r and n squared are positive, therefore the energy levels of the hydrogen atom are negative. Replace H, C and R by their values. Therefore, in SI units, the energy level of a quantum number n is given by this equation. We know that 1 electron volt equals 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 19 joules. Then 1 joule equals 1 over 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 19 electron volts. Replace joule by 1 over 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 19. This is going to be, in electron volts, the energy level of a quantum number n equals minus 13.6 over n squared, where n is a whole number and greater than or equal to 1. Since n is a non-zero whole number, we can conclude that the energy of the atom is quantized.
Now, let's use this expression in order to calculate the values of some of the energy levels of the hydrogen atom. Replace n in this equation by 1, you will get E1, which is equal to minus 13.6 electron volts. This is the ground state. Replace n by 2, you will get E2, which is equal to minus 3.4 electron volts. This is the energy of the second energy level, or the first excited state. Replace n by 3. You will get E3 equals minus 1.51 electron volts. This is the energy of the second excited state. And so on. Finally, when n approaches infinity, En approaches zero. This is the ionized state.
Focus, please. This is important.
When an electron is liberated from the atom, no more interaction takes place between the electron and the nucleus. So the atom becomes in the ionized state. Then we take this state as a reference level or the zero level, and it corresponds to E infinity equals zero. The energies of the other levels are negative because the electron needs energy to reach the state of E infinity equals zero. Also, in one of the previous slides, we proved that the energies of the other levels are negative.
As we have seen in the previous slide, when n equals infinity, the electron is no longer bound to the nucleus because E infinity equals zero. Ionization corresponds to a transition from the ground state to the ionized state. Then, we define the ionization energy of an atom as the minimum energy needed to liberate an electron from the ground state of the atom. Therefore, the ionization energy equals E infinity minus E1, which is equal to minus E1. But E1 is negative, then minus E1 must be positive. For the hydrogen atom, the ionization energy equals E infinity minus E1, but E1 equals minus 13.6 electron volts, then the ionization energy of the hydrogen atom is 13.6 electron volts.
In a previous episode whose title is Bohr model for the hydrogen atom, we have seen that a photon can excite the atom from a lower energy level EL to a higher energy level EH if its energy is exactly equal to the energy difference between EH and EL. But what happens if the photon energy is greater than or equal to the energy difference between E infinity and EL? In this case, the atom might absorb the photon, and then the electron will use part of the photon energy to become liberated, and it will leave the atom with the other part in the form of kinetic energy, and the atom becomes ionized. Let's study the case when the atom is in the ground state. In this case, EL or E lower equals E1. So E infinity minus E lower becomes E infinity minus E1, which is the ionization energy of the atom. So when the energy of the photon is greater than or equal to the ionization energy of the atom, so the electron could be liberated. And the kinetic energy of the liberated electron equals the energy of the incident photon minus the ionization energy of the atom.